Welcome to our next episode of Learning the Basics of Abacus. In this episode, we will learn about different parts of Abacus and the working system of Abacus. Okay, so here you can see an instrument. This instrument is called as Abacus. Okay, in this Abacus, we have different parts. You can see there are some yellow color circles here. These are called as beads. These are called as beads. These beads can go up and go down. You can find some beads towards downside, and you can find some beads towards upside. Okay, the beads which are towards lower side are called as lower beads, and the beads which are towards upper side are called as upper beads. You can find a bar in between the lower beads and upper beads, which are separating the lower bead and upper bead in two different parts. This particular bar is called as beam. This particular bar is called as beam, B-E-A-M, or reckoning bar. And in this beam, you can find some black color or red color dots. These dots are called as unit dots. These dots are called as unit dots. And you can find some white color rods which are consisting these beads. Okay, so these are called as rods. And this outer part of this abacus is called as frame. So basically, I told you there are five parts. Okay, the first part is lower bead, the second part is upper bead, the third part is beam, the fourth part is unit dot, and the fifth part is rod. Okay, now let me give you an example before coming to the working of abacus. Suppose I am writing here 123. Now, if we want to know the base values, the place values of this number, so 3 is in ones place, or officially it is called as unit place. 2 is in tens place, 3 is in hundred place, and so on. It starts with units, tens, hundreds, thousand, 10,000, 1 lakh, and so on. Okay, so in abacus also, we will start from a particular point which is called as unit point. And wherever we can find this unit place, wherever these unit dots are there. We have 4 unit dots here. So we can take this line as a unit, or this line, or this line, or this line. According to our need, we can change the unit place. For our convenience, I am taking this place, this first place where this unit dot is there, as a unit place. Okay, so when I took this unit dot as a unit in my abacus, this particular rod is converted into unit rod. This is a unit place rod. Now let's check what are the values of this unit place. I told you in a particular rod there are 5 beads. Let's use my hand like this. So there are 4 beads towards downside and 1 bit towards upside. Now in every unit rod, each lower bit has a value of 1 unit. This is called as 1. This is also 1, this is also 1, this is also 1, and this is also 1. And this upper bit has a value of 5. This is a 5. For your understanding, I am telling you, these are all 1 rupee chocolates, and this is a 5 rupees chocolate. Okay, so here you can see this is 1, 1, 1, 1, and this is 5. Okay, left to unit. If this is a unit place, left to unit, this place is called as tens place. Here you can see this is a tens place. So here it is a tens place. In the tens rod, each lower bit has a value of 10. This is also 10, this is also 10, this is also 10, this is also 10. And the upper bit has a value of 50. As this is 5, this is 50. This is 1, this is 10. It increases 10 times. This is 1, 10, 100, 1000, 10,000, 1 lakh, 10 lakh, 1 crore, 10 crore, 100 crores, 1000 crores, 10,000 crores, and 1 lakh crore. We can count up to this. Similarly, the upper bit is 5, 50, 500, 5000, 50,000, 5 lakh, 50 lakh, and so on. Okay, now you can see this beats can go up and go down. This beats can move up and down. This upper bit can also move up and move down. Okay, now I told you the values, but when these values come into existence. Okay, so let's memorize a simple thing. Whenever any bead, either it's a lower bead or an upper bead, whenever any bead will touch to this beam, then only it will gain the value. It means if one bead goes up and touches to this beam, then only it has some value. If it is not touching, then it's not have any value. Okay, so now we can start the calculation. So as lots of small kids will be there to learn this abacus, I will teach you like a small kid, so for better understanding. Now let's see, we are using only two fingers, either in the right hand or in the left hand, we will use only two fingers. One is thumb and one is index finger. Now let's see what is the use of this thumb. We will use this thumb only to make the lower beads up. Lower beads up. If we want to make the lower beads up, then we will do this thumb. To make the lower beads down, we will use index finger. Like this, we will use the index finger. To make the upper bead down, also we will use the index finger. And to make the upper bead up, also we will use index finger. So again I am telling, we will use the thumb finger only to make the lower beads up. The work of thumb is only that much, and all other things we will do in our index finger, like making the lower beads down, upper bead down and upper bead up. So this is the function of our hand to use this abacus. Now let's learn this function of abacus in a playway method. Suppose these are all chocolates. Suppose these are all chocolates. Okay. And this lower part is a shop. He's a shopkeeper uncle. He's sitting here. Okay. And he has all these chocolates in his downside rack and his upside rack. And this beam is you. Okay, this is you. Now if you have chocolate, now do you have any chocolate? Now if any chocolate will touch you, that is yours. If any chocolate is not touching you, that is not yours. Okay, so you have now zero chocolates, because no chocolates are touching to you, with you. Okay, all the chocolates are with shopkeeper uncle. Now let's start the calculation. Suppose shopkeeper uncle gave you one chocolate. So he gave you one chocolate. We will use this thumb to give this chocolate. Okay. Now one chocolate is touching to you. So now you have one chocolate. Okay. Now shopkeeper uncle is giving you one more chocolate. So you have one chocolate and added one more chocolate. So you have now two chocolates. Shopkeeper uncle gave you one more chocolate, so 2 and 1, that is 3. Shopkeeper uncle gave you one more chocolate. Now you have 1, 2, 3, 4 chocolates. Now you have 4 chocolates, right? And if you will eat all the 4 chocolates, what will happen? You will get cavities, right? So what we will do, we will not eat all the 4 chocolates. We will give one chocolate to our friend. You have 4 chocolates, out of that one chocolate you give. Okay, if it comes to you, that is plus. If it goes out from you, that is minus. So 4 minus 1, that is 3. One more chocolate to your brother, so now you have 2 chocolates. One more chocolate to your mama or mother, now you have 1 chocolate. And the last chocolate we will not give to anyone. What we will do, we will eat. So that chocolate also we eat. So we have 0 chocolates. Okay. So you understood. If one bead from down to up, this is plus 1, again plus 1, 2, again plus 1, 3, again plus 1, 4. If it is goes down from this beam, then it is minus. Now you have 4 and 1 subtract, that is 3, minus 1, 2. We need to calculate only the beads which are touching to this beam. So here only 2 beads are touching, this is 2. Again minus 1, so this is 1, again minus 1, this is 0. Now let's come to the upper bit. These are all 1 rupee chocolates and this is a 5 rupees chocolate. In 5 rupees you will get a small 5 star chocolate. Now shopkeeper uncle gave you 1 5 star chocolate. So you have 5. This is called as plus 5. And if you will use it or if you will give it to someone, this is minus 5. So this is the use of the beads in unit place. Each lower bit has a value of 1, 1, 1, 1. The upper bit has a value of 5 and the value comes into existence when it will touch to this beam. So let's do a small calculation. For you I am writing, suppose it is 2 plus 1 plus 1. So how we will do? The first number is 2. So what we will do? We will make 2 bits up in our thumb. So 1 and 2. So this is first 2. Then second number is plus 1. So again we will do plus 1 here. So answer is 3. Again we need to do plus 1. So answer is again plus 1. So the answer is 4. So you understand how we are doing addition? Let's practice some more examples how to do addition and subtraction in abacus. Okay, let's take this question 2 plus 1 plus 5. So the first question is 2. So in thumb we will do plus 2. 2 bits at a time we will make it up. And then the next question is plus 1. So plus 1 means again 1 bit up. So now that we got the answer 3, then the next question is plus 5. Okay, where it is 5 is there? It is 1, we don't have 5 downside, we have 5 upside. So here the upper bit, if we will make it down in index finger, this is 5 plus. So 2 plus 1 plus 5, we got this much answer. How we will calculate? We will calculate from upside. This is 5 plus 1 6 plus 1 7 plus 1 8. So the answer is 8. Let's do the next question. 5 plus 2 plus 2. Okay, so first we will do 5. Where we can find 5? On the upper side. So we will do plus 5 here. Then again plus 2. That is plus 2, 7. Again plus 2. That is. So now final answer is 5 plus 1, 6 plus 1, 7 plus 1, 8 plus 1, 9. So the answer is 9. Let's take this example 8 plus 1 minus 4. Let's take 8. How we will take 8? Before taking that, we will do one more sum. Suppose it is 4 minus 1 minus 2. Okay, so first we will take 4. So we will take 1, 2, 3, 4. 1 plus 1, 2 plus 1, 3 plus 1, 4. From this 4, we need to subtract 1. Plus means we will do in thumb and minus or less or subtraction we will do in index finger. So from 4, we need to subtract 1. So we will make 1 bit down. So now the answer is 3. Now from this again, we will do minus 2. So how many beats we need to do in down? Because it is 2, so 2 beats. So we will count here 1, 2 and 2 beats we will make it down. So the final answer is 1. 4 minus 1, 3 minus 2 is 1. So this is subtraction. If we are doing like this, this is plus 1. If we are doing like this, this is minus 1. If we are doing like this, this is plus 2. If we are doing like this, this is minus 2. This is plus 4. This is minus 4. This is plus 5. This is minus 5. How we will make 6? 4 is here, 5 is here, but we don't have 6. So how we will do 6? 6 means 5 and 1. So 5 plus 1 plus. So this is 6. Now how we'll do 7? 5 plus 2, that is 7. How we will do 9? 5 plus 4, 6, 7, 8, 9. So like this we can do numbers up to 9. Now let's come to this question. Here the first question is 8 plus 1 minus 4. So 8, I told you just now how to make 6, 7, 8, 9. So 8 means 5 plus 1, 6 plus 1, 7 plus 1, 8. So we did 8, again plus 1. Plus 1 means again 1 bit up, plus 1. So 8 plus 1, 9. And from this 9, we need to subtract 4. So 4 means minus 4 or less 4. So from downside, we will subtract 4 bits. 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 bits down. And we got the final answer, that is 5. Let's do one more question in this. So 5 plus 1 minus 6. Okay, so first we will do add 5. Then add 1. So from downside we will make 1 bit up, 6. And from this we will subtract 6. So how we will subtract 6? Again, 6 means 5 and 1. So we will subtract 5 here and we will subtract 1 here. So answer is 0. So like this we can do the addition of single digit. Okay. So in next episode we will learn how to do addition and subtraction of double digit, triple digit and more. Thank you all of you for watching this episode.